are one more week estimated before Slam Fest. This is FNW Crash Episode 3. We're in Uniondale, New York. And we're gonna start things off with Patricia Kaplan. Patricia Kaplan looking for a little payback from her last match on Grand Prix, getting interrupted by Reiko. Reiko blindsiding Patricia Kaplan in a jealous rage because she was in a match with the now former women's champion Revy. And I say former champion because Jennifer One cashed in after Patricia Kaplan pinned Revy, and now Jennifer One is the new FNW champion. Go watch Grand Prix for more info.
And her opponent from Osaka, Japan, Rei Cho.
And Reiko, the green-eyed culprit, interfered in Patricia Kaplan's match, hitting Patricia Kaplan with that finisher of hers, almost costing Patricia Kaplan the match, but that interference lit a fire under Patricia Kaplan. Patricia Kaplan gained the victory over the former women's champion. Oh, that's a close one. Reiko almost setting her hair on fire there. Ladies and gentlemen, third episode of Crash, our brand new third show here in FNW. And right away, Reiko with the overhead. Reiko standing backwards, moonsault there. And now here comes Patricia Kaplan. Patricia Kaplan got Reiko up in the ropes. And Reiko, reversal with a chin breaker. And oh, nice missile drop kick there. Missing the kick. Patricia Kaplan quick on her feet, getting out of the way. And here comes Patricia Kaplan, full head of steam. Got Reiko, sending Reiko's face right into the middle turnbuckle. And Patricia Kaplan got the headlock in. Reiko, another chin breaker, going for another drop kick, miss, no one home that time. And there goes Reiko, hard lightning speed fist from Patricia Kaplan in retort, sending Reiko down to the mat. And right back into the middle turnbuckle goes the head of Reiko. Patricia Kaplan is taking out her frustrations now, making Reiko pay for that interference. Standing facebreaker. Reiko been on a kind of a salty, bitter tear because every opportunity she gets for the women's title has been blocked, or she just straight up losing the match. Reiko acting out of frustration. And now she is paying for it. Patricia Kaplan not playing any games here tonight. Hard right sending Reiko off the mat. Patricia Kaplan going up top. Reiko trying to get to a vertical base, and oh, sidestepping, no one home for Patricia Kaplan. Reiko snap suplex on the outside. These ladies taking the fight outside of the ring. Ooh, hard chop right into the firm breasts of Patricia Kaplan. Patricia Kaplan with a flurry of kicks. Referee to the count of six. Reiko getting to the outside. Ooh, backbreaker. And the referee is going to start the count over, but no, Reiko taking the action back into the ring. Ooh, hard hit to the back. And a spinning Kaplan kick. And hooking the leg. Patricia Kaplan with the victory. Patricia Kaplan getting some payback here tonight.
Here is your winner, Patricia Kaplan.
Congratulations to Patricia Kaplan getting that payback, like I said. What's next down the line for Patricia Kaplan now that she has a victory in the books over the women's champion? But as we know, she's the champion no more. Kareem Alpha versus Ramon Ace coming up next. Kareem Alpha. Alpha, shot of our cameras in the back room. There he is, coming through the crowd like he used to. Kareem Alpha in the building tonight. Logic getting a look over from our FNW doctors after Kareem Alpha and Logic went to war with the tag team champions on Blitz. Even though they lost that matchup, C2 gave DOG a one heck of a fight. I can't wait for Slamfest when C2 faces the Dogs once again for the Tag Team Championships. Ramon Ace coming out here with a little spring in his step. Usually is nothing but aggression from both members of DOG, but Ramon Ace feeling a little springy. I think he believes that he has, or DOG has, the match in the bag for Slamfest. A little bit of cockiness showing, and hey, you can't blame him. DOG dominant tag team once again on top of the mountain as tag team champions. We're going to start things off. Lock up right in the center of the ring. Kareem Alpha getting pushed up into the corner. Lock is in. Referee is going to have to separate these two. No cheap shots. That's a good thing to see. But no, Ramon Ace. And oh, Kareem Alpha now with the Luthes press. Hard shot to the back of Ramon Ace. Ramon Ace now just shrugging off the attempt. And Kareem Alpha, oh, both now shrugging off each other's attempts. Supreme Alpha now. Starting to bring the fight to Ramon Ace. Ramon Ace taking down Alpha. And Alpha rolls out to take a breather. Alpha on the outside. Full back suplex. Nice sharp kicks from both competitors. As Ramon Ace tosses Alpha back inside to the ring. Follow up with some hard stomps to the right leg. Oh, car kick to the midsection. And a nice meat hook clothesline by Alpha. And the hook in the leg. Gonna kick out right away. Ramon Ace. Still plenty in the tank. Ramon Ace getting back up to his feet and follow up with another meat hook clothesline. Ladies and gentlemen, coming up after some more shows. Annual show Slam Fest. Our Slam Fest card is shaping up to be very, very special. Later on tonight, Kevin Knight goes one-on-one with Big Z. Big Z looking to become number one contender for Kevin Knight, United States Championship at Slamfest. And oh, going for the high cross body, caught by Alpha and dropped. Nice shoulder tackle. Off the apron. Team Alpha in pursuit. Here comes Kareem Alpha. Those hard overhead rights. And oh! First backdrop to the outside. Ramon Ace. And Kareem Alpha going at it here tonight. And Kareem Alpha got Ramon Ace up in the flapjack. And go for the super kick. It was blocked first. But the second attempt connected. Two. And the kick out right at two. Hard stomp to the hands of Ace and into the Steiner recliner. Or a variant of the Steiner recliner. And Alpha looking for that Alpha drop. Alpha! Alpha drop! Going for the cover. One, two. Kareem Alpha with the victor. The victory. Alpha, very impressive, looking to have C2 going strong into Slam Fest. And there it is, that Alpha drop connecting. Kareem Alpha with the victory. One half of C2, Kareem Alpha, making his team look strong going into Slam Fest. Once again, congratulations. Coming up next, TV champion Brian Cannon goes one-on-one with Adam Young. And that is next. he is, full of swag and confidence.
Making his way to the ring from Orlando, Florida, weighing in at 220 pounds, the television champion, Brian Cannon.
And Brian Cannon, the reigning, defending television champion. Brian Cannon looking to go in, or I shouldn't say looking to, he is going in to SlamFest as TV champion, and I know he's looking to exit still TV champion, but can he do that when this guy is on his heels? Adam Young with the disrespect on the first match against Brian Cannon. But Adam Young has been reprimanded and told that if he wants a television championship shot, he has to drop the attitude. But will he do that? We don't know, but Brian Cannon doesn't care either way. Brian Cannon actually welcomes the challenge for the television championship at SlamFest. Can Adam Young pull off a victory tonight, and will he be able to become television champion? Adam Young got his eyes set on Brian Cannon's television championship. Adam Young coming out strong out the gate. Flapjack to Cannon. Adam Young now looking very impressive out the gate here against the television champion. But here comes Brian Cannon. Brian Cannon with a flurry of punches. Just ducking the attempt. And turning Adam Young inside out. Ladies and gentlemen, allow me to plug a comrade in arms, Bowser Flatliner, host of BNRF Wrestling, over on the Bowser Flatliner Twitch stream. Go to Twitch, type in Bowser Flatliner, and get ready for more CAW. CAW action on BNRF. Adam Young there with the backdrop. Brian Cannon hitting that reversal and impressive meat hook clothesline. And Brian Cannon, sharp elbow to Adam Young. Going for the cover and a kick out. Adam Young, plenty in the tank still. Yeah, Adam Young taking a punishment out here. Brian Cannon making Adam Young pay for the disrespect. And what I mean by that, the last time these two faced each other, Brian Cannon trying to show a little sportsmanship, but Adam Young took a chunk of salt out of the salt mines. Right into Brian Cannon's face. Brian Cannon didn't appreciate it. Adam Young a little frustrated that he missed the opportunity to become the first ever the middleweight championship match become the winner. The winner of that match went to Chris Cash. Chris Cash, the first ever middleweight champion here in FNW. And Brian Cannon hooking the leg, and no, Adam Young kicked out, and now Brian Cannon calling for the end. Adam Young now has his eyes set on Brian Cannon's television championship. Brian Cannon going up top. And, oh, shot to the elbow right to the neck and chest of Adam Young. And Adam Young, route reversal. Adam Young shook off that elbow drop. Adam Young sending Brian Cannon up into the ropes. Adam Young with the styling leg drop there. The forever young leg drop. And a kick out. And Young now looked like he was going for a finisher. But Brian Cannon sidestepping the assault. And here comes Cannon. Adam Young wobbly on the ropes, going over the top rope. And Brian Cannon looking to hit the full cannon. Full loaded cannon. To the outside, opening up Adam Young. Adam Young now busted open, getting that spark of adrenaline in his system, but Cannon with that nice Olympic slam there. And an old kick out at 2.9. Brian a little frustrated at the referee. And here comes Brian Cannon. Brian Cannon, full body splash. Ducking and hitting. Hitting Young with that double underhook into the submission hold. Is Adam Young going to tap out? Referee asking Young if he wants to tap out. Young refusing to tap out. Here comes Brian Cannon. Loaded cannon! One, two, three, Brian Cannon, the winner. And you love to see it, ladies and gentlemen. And Adam Young now, look at the blood on Brian Cannon's hands. It's Brian Cannon now. Adam Young showing a little bit of maturity. Says that he'll see him at Slamfest for the television championship.
This is an ordinary man.
Honey, I'm home.
I made dinner.
This is a hungry man.
Baby, I'm home.
How was work today?
A few body slams, the usual. I'm starving. What's for dinner?
I made your favorite, hungry man.
A whole pound of food men love. Fried chicken, mashed potatoes, corn and pudding.
Mind if I join you?
Hungry man from Swanson. It's good to be full.
Get your own sucker!
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. Get your hungry man dinner. Away from this guy especially, because here comes Big Z. Big Z looking for an opportunity at Slamfest for the United States Championship as he faces Kevin Knight. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you got your seatbelts fastened because this is going to be two giants in the ring.
From Brooklyn, New York, weighing in at 383 pounds,
Big Z. We're about to probably see a preview of Godzilla versus Kong here tonight. As these two giants go to war. Ladies and gentlemen, if Big Z scores the victory here over Kevin Knight, it will be Big Z versus Kevin Knight at Slamfest for the United States Championship. Here comes the United States champion. This ought to be one chaotic match.
And his opponent from Sydney, Australia, weighing in at 350 pounds, the United States champion, Kevin.
Kevin Knight look like he is ready and he welcomes the challenge. Ladies and gentlemen, this is not the first time these two went to war. If you remember at the first Slam Fest, and right away Kevin Knight with the Superman punch and sending Big Z over the ropes. As I was saying, these two face each other at the first Slam Fest, that was for the Internet Championship. Kevin Knight, the victor of that match. Kevin, look at the strength of Kevin Knight. Dropping Big Z onto the outside. Big Z gotta be like 400 pounds of pure muscle. Kevin Knight is no slouch either. Every time these two seems to hit contact, Superman punch to Kevin Knight. And Kevin Knight going to work. And Big Z with the reversal. Big Z, hard hits to the midsection. Here comes Big Z, big boot to Kevin Knight. Oh, strength of Big Z sending Kevin Knight clearly across the ring. Kevin Knight now up in the ropes, Big Z. And now Big Z gets to show off his impressive strength as he bench presses Kevin Knight just as he did him and dropping him to the mat. Going for the cover, one and a kick out. And so the first. Is that like a reverse STO there? And a big splash from the top rope. We rarely see Big Z go up top like that. But Kevin Knight shaking it off. Big Z with a reversal of his own, taking out the legs of Kevin Knight. And it's that gut-wrench suplex. So far, this match is a banger. Big Z now taking it tonight. All right, what the heck? I thought Big Z was done. Big Z. And look out. Big Z behind Big Z. Tony Gavin, border runner. Tony Gavin hitting the border runner on Big Z. Tony Gavin isn't done. Two and a kick out. Tony Gavin hitting Big Z with the border runner. I think Big Z thought he was done with Tony Gavin, but Tony Gavin hitting that border runner on Big Z almost costing him this matchup. Big Z with the clothesline to Kevin Knight. I don't think Kevin Knight appreciated the interference as well. And I don't even know if Kevin Knight even knew what took place. How could you not? But oh, into the triangle. The triangle choke submission move. Is Big Z gonna tap? It is locked in. But Big Z, look at Big Z. Big Z is powering out of the triangle hold. The Devil's Gate. And oh, snake eyes right into the corner. And Big Z picking Kevin Knight up. Big Z has got to be livid right now. And he is taking out his frustrations under Big Z. What is Big Z doing? Big Z, totally frustrated. And Big Z, oh, with that slam. Kevin Knight. And look at these two. And now Big Z now with the gut punches. It's the unstoppable force right against the immovable object here on this episode of Crash. Tony Gavin sticking his nose into this matchup. Big Z probably looking into the crowd, trying to see if Tony Gavin. But look at the strength on display here by Big Z once again, sending Kevin Knight to the mat. And Kevin Knight still alive, taking down Big Z with that shoulder tackle, and now. I think these two are going to bench press each other forever. Pause. Two big meaty men slapping meat, as the saying goes. As Kevin Knight tries to survey or figure out what to do to put Big Z away. But Kevin Knight now. Kevin Knight got Big Z up. Oh, brain buster! And oh! Kevin Knight with that, like, brain buster pile driver there. I gotta think of a name for that one. A Big Z shaking off the cobwebs. And oh, sidestepping Kevin Knight. Kevin Knight now burning that midnight oil. Big Z now still in the fight. It has been reversal after reversal by these two, and Big Z going for that Big Z slam. And evoking the leg, one, two, and a kick out. Wants that United States Championship opportunity. Kevin Knight now hooking the leg. And oh, almost. Submission hold is in. Kevin Knight got him. And oh! Big Z with that breakout stun. And then a big boot to Kevin Knight. Big Z now got that Z claw locked in. Referee looking to see if Kevin Knight's going to tap out. One, two. Kevin Knight with an inch of power. Looks like he is running out of steam here. Something we rarely see from Kevin Knight, and a nice uppercut. Kevin Knight got that adrenaline shot in, and Big Z with a hard punch. And Kevin Knight now, Kevin Knight with his gut punches. Big Z. Big Z on the hands of Kevin Knight. Big Z going for another Big Z fall away slam. Kevin Knight. Kevin Knight with a reversal and a kick up. And Kevin Knight a spine buster. What a beautiful spine buster by Kevin Knight. We got to take another look at that one. Nice, beautiful spine buster by Kevin Knight. And Kevin Knight now, nice combination. Kevin Knight looking to put this away. Kevin Knight, verdict pedigree time. Boom! The cover is made, two. And Kevin Knight is your winner. There will be hell to pay for Tony Gavin's interference. These two put on one banger of a match, I must say. But you damn well know that Tony Gavin now has to look around every corner, have eyes on the back of his head, because a frustrated Big Z will be waiting. And now, ladies and gentlemen, our main event, as Murphy goes one-on-one with Chris Cash. And there he is. Taking a little bit of a breather from BNRF over here.
Making his way to the ring. from Baltimore, Maryland, weighing in at 220 pounds, Murphy!
And the power of the children in his back corner, Murphy, unfortunately getting squashed by Kevin Knight in his debut match. Now Murphy looking to pick his battles a little bit more wisely as he's facing someone a little bit more his size, as he's facing the middleweight champion Chris Cash here in the main event of Crash. Here comes the middleweight champion.
And his opponent from Detroit, Michigan, weighing in at 215 pounds, the middleweight champion, Chris Cashman.
Chris Cash. Now the middleweight champion. It's been rechristened from the internet championship. Chris Cash making good on his promise since his return here to FNW, saying that this time he is bound and determined to get some gold around his waist. First episode of FNW Crash, making good on that promise, becoming champion. And now, Chris Cash faces, and oh, right out the gate, and a kip up, just taking the fight to Murphy. Hard kicks to the chest. Murphy right out the gate, probably still feeling the effects of that that squashing that he suffered from Kevin Knight, his debut match. Murphy showing homage to his idol, Terry Bogard. As you see him in his entrance wearing the Fatal Fury jacket, he's still got the red hat on, the blue jeans. I guess he couldn't afford any, What is it? The Converse? Was it? Is it the Doc Martens? Yeah. Nice suplex by Murphy. Murphy here in FNW doesn't have the bunny entourage as you see he has in BNRF. Looking impressive, and oh, nice hip toss by Murphy. Into the turnbuckle clothesline. And here comes Murphy. And oh, Chris Cash with the backdrop. Got the stomps in. Here comes Murphy. And Murphy, okay, he's sizing up Chris Cash. But Chris Cash now, I guess Murphy changes his strategy. And looking for a stunner. And oh, Chris Cash with the kip up there. Ladies and gentlemen, if you're just tuning in, this is our main event. Chris Cash. Taking it to Murphy. And a leg drop on the arm. And think Chris Cash's strategy is here to prevent Murphy from taking out the power out of his power dunk. And the hard chops exchange. And Murphy sending Chris Cash soaring to the outside. The kick to the back is missed. Murphy hitting face full of stairs there. And oh! Chris Cash sending Murphy right into those steel steps repeatedly. And Murphy catching the leg of Cash. The referee at the count of six. These two bet again. Cash into the steel steps. Murphy running back into the ring. Murphy looking to end this match in a count out. Chris Cash. Chris Cash making it back into the count of nine. And Murphy, the gut wrench slam there. Nice leg drop by Murphy. Murphy looking very impressive in this match. More than he did in his debut. Hard kick to the back of Cash. And the GMs I know are watching. If Murphy hits a victory here, he could very well be inserted into the middleweight match at Slamfest, making it a triple threat. And here comes Chris Cash. Chris Cash with a nice combination there. Murphy holding on to the ropes. And Chris Cash, I think he tripped right there. And Chris Cash waited too long, Murphy. And oh, here's on the reversal. And Chris Cash, tornado DDT off of the middle rope. Headlock is set in. What is Murphy gonna do here? And Murphy with a reversal right into his own headlock. And oh, I think he was looking for the cash flow, but Murphy got the knees right into the face. Didn't get all of the cash flow in, but oh, super kick to Murphy. And here's the cover into a pin. Look at that bridge pin. And Chris Cash goes away with the win. Very impressive matchup here tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining for another episode of FNW Crash. I think we got like about three more shows until Slamfest, but the card is still shaping up. Look at this beautiful bridge pin by Chris Cash. And congratulations to Chris Cash on the victory. Ladies and gentlemen, another episode of Crash in the Books. Thanks for joining us. We will see you next time. Rub shoulders, the money too young. See me when it gets older, your bank account grow up. Mine says 1000 older. Damn near out the rear truck when I roll up. Motor till I close up, it's all basic. I've been spending hundreds since